Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss one of the major metabolic pathway of carbohydrate metabolism, that is glycolysis. In today's video, we will discuss definition, what are the various steps, significance, regulation and energetics of glycolysis along with NEET PG MCQs. This particular topic can be asked as a short note or long answer question in theory exam. To download lecture notes and other interesting stuff related to biochemistry, please visit website biochemistrybasics.com. So first, what is the another name of glycolysis? So glycolysis pathway is also known as Amidon-Meyerhoff pathway. Now we will see definition of glycolysis. So glucose is split into 2-3 carbon pyruvate molecules under aerobic conditions, that is in the presence of oxygen, or lactate under anaerobic conditions, that is in the absence of oxygen, along with production of small quantity of energy in the form of ATP. That is the definition of glycolysis. Now we will see site of the reaction. The site of the reaction of glycolysis is all the reaction steps of glycolysis take place in the cytoplasm, that is in the cytosol of the cell. That is regarding definition and site of the reactions of glycolysis. Now we will see significance of glycolysis. The first and important significance of glycolysis is, glycolysis is the only pathway that takes place in all the cells of body. Second significance of glycolysis is, glycolysis is the only source of energy in RBCs, that is erythrocytes. Glycolysis is the preliminary step for the complete oxidation of glucose. Glycolytic pathway may be considered as the preliminary step before complete oxidation of glucose. Another significance of glycolysis is in strenuous exercise when muscle tissue lacks enough oxygen, anaerobic glycolysis forms the major source of energy for the muscles for muscle contraction. Glycolytic pathway also provide carbon skeleton for the synthesis of various non-essential amino acid as well as for the glycerol part of fat. And the last significance of glycolysis is majority of the reactions of glycolysis are reversible, which are also used for gluconeogenesis, that is synthesis of new carbohydrate from non-carbohydrate precursors like lactate, glucogenic amino acids, acetyl-CoA and glycerol part of fat. So these are the significance of glycolysis pathway. Now we will see steps of glycolysis. So the reactions of glycolysis are divided into two phases. First phase is the energy requiring or energy utilizing phase, and the second phase is energy generating or ATP synthesizing phase. This is the picture showing the first phase of glycolysis, which is also called as a preparatory phase, that is conversion of glucose up to glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, and the second phase is conversion of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate up to pyruvate, which is also called as a energy generating or ATP synthesizing phase. Now we will see reactions of glycolysis in detail. The first reaction of preparatory phase is phosphorylation of glucose into glucose 6-phosphate, and it is done by hexokinase in the muscle, fine, and this hexokinase enzyme is inhibited by its product, that is glucose 6-phosphate, and this hexokinase has a low Km value, means it has a high affinity for the glucose and it is present in the muscle. Fine, and it is not induced by insulin. Another isoenzyme of hexokinase, that is glucokinase, which is present in the liver as well as in the beta cells of pancreas, can also convert glucose into glucose 6-phosphate. But this glucokinase enzyme has a high Km value, which means it has a low affinity for the glucose, and it will act only when blood glucose value is greater than 100 mg per deciliter, and it is induced by insulin and it is not inhibited by glucose 6-phosphate. And this is the first irreversible step of glycolysis. And over here there is a conversion of one molecule of ATP into ADP. So that is the first step of glycolysis. And after converting glucose into glucose 6-phosphate, This glucose 6 phosphate can also enter into the gluconeogenesis pathway, HMP shunt pathway, glycogenesis or glycogenolysis. So that is the fat of glucose 6 phosphate. After that, this glucose 6 phosphate is isomerized into fructose 6 phosphate by phosphohexose isomerase enzyme. Over here, aldose sugar is converting into the keto sugar. So that is the second step of glycolysis. Now, fructose 6-phosphate is again phosphorylated by phosphofructokinase 1 enzyme into fructose 1,6-bisphosphate. And over here again there is a utilization of one molecule of ATP. Fine. And this is second irreversible step of glycolysis. And this is the permutate step of glycolysis, which means one fructose 1,6-bisphosphate is synthesized, it should enter into the glycolytic pathway. This is the first committed or rate limiting step of glycolysis. And this is the second irreversible step of glycolysis, which is catalyzed by phosphofructokinase. Right? After fructose 1,6-bisphosphate is synthesized, it is split into 2-3 carbon containing molecule, that is glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate and dihydroxyacetone phosphate, by aldolase enzyme. Aldolase is the example of lyase enzyme. So this is the preparatory phase or first phase of glycolysis. In the preparatory phase, there is a utilization of two molecules of ATP. That is in the first step of the glycolysis, and another ATP is utilized in the third step of glycolysis. Now, second phase is energy generating phase. So the glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, which is synthesized in the first phase. Fine. And there was also synthesis of dihydroxyacetone phosphate. Now this dihydroxyacetone phosphate is converted into another glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate by phosphotriose isomerase enzyme. So there will be the two glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate over here. So this molecules of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate is oxidized via glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase enzyme, and it gets converted into high energy containing molecule, that is 1,3-BPG, fine, that is 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate. And over here there is a synthesis of two molecules of NADH, as NAD plus is getting converted into NADH plus H plus. So in this step there is a synthesis of molecules of NADH, because 2 glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate is getting converted into molecules of 1,3-BPG. And this glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate dehydrogenase enzyme can be inhibited by iodoacetate. Fine. So 2 NADH, which is synthesized in this step, that is 6th step of glycolysis, will enter into the electron transport chain and will give rise to the 2.5 molecules of ATP for one molecule of NADH. So if two molecules of NADH are getting entry into the electron transport chain, then over here there will be the synthesis of 5 molecules of ATP, but this will possible only in aerobic glycolysis. If there is an anaerobic glycolysis, then these two molecules of NADH will be utilized by lactate dehydrogenase enzyme that we will see later on. Fine. Up to 6th step, there is a synthesis of 1,3-BPG. Now this 1,3-BPG is getting converted into 3-phosphoglycerate via phosphoglycerate kinase enzyme, and this enzyme or this step is the example of substrate level phosphorylation, because over here there is a direct synthesis of ATP. Substrate level phosphorylation means there is a synthesis of ATP without going or without taking part in electron transport chain. And so this phosphoglycerate kinase is the example of substrate level phosphorylation. Fine. And this kinase reaction is the only reaction of glycolysis which is reversible, while other kinase reactions are irreversible. Fine. So over here there is a synthesis of two molecules of 3-phosphoglycerate. Now this 3-phosphoglycerate is converted into 2-phosphoglycerate via phosphoglycerate mutase enzyme. There is a synthesis of two molecules of 2-phosphoglycerate, fine, via mutase enzyme. And this molecules of 2-phosphoglycerate is converted into phosphoenol pyruvate by enolase enzyme. And over here, there is a removal of one molecule of H2O. And this enolase enzyme is inhibited by fluoride. That's why in the clinical laboratory, we are collecting samples for the glucose estimation in the fluoride vacuole. So this fluoride will inhibit the enolase enzyme and it will inhibit the glycolysis. Fine, so that is the reason why we are collecting the sample for the blood glucose estimation in fluoride vacuole. Now this two molecules of 2-phosphoenol pyruvate is converted into two molecules of pyruvate by pyruvate kinase enzyme, and it is the second example of substrate level phosphorylation. Over here there is a synthesis of two molecules of ADP, and again it is the irreversible step of glycolysis. First irreversible step of glycolysis was catalyzed by hexokinase or glucokinase. Second irreversible step of glycolysis was catalyzed by phosphofructokinase, and the third irreversible step of glycolysis is catalyzed by pyruvate kinase, and it is also example of substrate level phosphorylation. Another example of substrate level phosphorylation was 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate kinase. These are the two examples of glycolysis. Another enzyme which leads to the substrate level phosphorylation is the succinate thiokinase. It is an example of TCA cycle. So these are the three enzymes which are example of substrate level phosphorylation, which leads to substrate level phosphorylation. So this is the completion of aerobic glycolysis. So that means there is a conversion of glucose into two molecules of pyruvate with synthesis of some amount of energy. Now we will see anaerobic glycolysis, that is glycolysis in the absence of oxygen. In the absence of oxygen, this pyruvate will be converted into the lactate via lactate dehydrogenase enzyme. And over here there will be the conversion of NADH plus H plus into NAD plus, and this NADH, it will be coming from NADH which is synthesized at the end of the conversion of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate into 1,3-DPG via glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase enzyme. So NADH which is utilizing in this particular step will be coming from this step. Fine. So this is how anaerobic glycolysis occur, that is glycolysis in the absence of oxygen. Now we will see energetics of glycolysis. So first we will see energetics of glycolytic pathway under aerobic condition, which means when oxygen is available. So the first step that is hexokinase. Over there, there will be the utilization of one molecule of ATP. So we can write down it as a minus one. Then second enzyme, that is phosphofructokinase, which carried out third step of glycolysis. Again, over there was a utilization of one molecule of ATP. So we can write down it as a minus one. Now the fifth step, which was catalyzed by glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase. Over there was a synthesis of two molecules of NADH. One molecule of NADH will enter into the electron transport chain and it will give rise to the 2.5 molecules of ATP. After two molecules will get converted into the 5 molecules of ATP. Then sixth step, which was the example of substrate level phosphorylation, which was catalyzed by 1,3-BPG kinase. Over there again there is a synthesis of two molecules of ATP, and the ninth step, it was catalyzed by pyruvate kinase. Again, it was the example of substrate level phosphorylation, and over there was a synthesis of two molecules of ATP. So at the end of the aerobic glycolysis, there will be the total 9 molecules of ATP will be synthesized, but there is also utilization of two molecules of ATP. So 9 minus 2, which will lead to the 7 molecules of ATP. So at the end of the aerobic glycolysis, total 7 molecules of ATP will be synthesized. Now we will see energy yield per molecule of glucose in the glycolytic pathway under anaerobic condition. So the first and third step will remain same, that is hexokinase and phosphofructokinase. Over there, there will be the utilization of one molecule of ATP. Now, fifth step, which was catalyzed by triazidyhyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase. Over there, there was a synthesis of two molecules of NADH. But these two molecules of NADH was utilized by lactate dehydrogenase. So there will be no synthesis of ATP. Fine. This NADH will not enter into the electron transport chain. So this fifth step will not be there. Directly, there will be the sixth step. That is conversion of 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate kinase. Sorry, sixth step that was catalyzed by 1,3-BPG kinase. Over there, there is synthesis of two molecules of ATP. And the ninth step that was catalyzed by pyruvate kinase. Over there, again, two molecules of ATP. So the final ATP which are synthesized at the end of anaerobic glycolysis will be 4 minus 2, that is 2 molecules of ATP. Fine. Now we will see what are the numbers of ATP generated per molecule of glucose when it is completely oxidized through glycolysis plus citric acid cycle under aerobic conditions. Net generation in the glycolytic pathway, as we have seen, that is 7 molecules of ATP, and generation in pyruvate dehydrogenase reaction, that is conversion of pyruvate to the acetyl-CoA, that is 5 molecules of ATP, and this acetyl-CoA, when it will enter into the citric acid cycle or TCA cycle, will give rise to the 20 molecules of ATP. Fine. So net generation of ATP from one glucose molecule will be 32 molecules of ATP under aerobic condition. Remember all this count, because this particular things are frequently asked in various entrance examination. The net generation of ATP from one glucose molecule under aerobic condition is 32. Now we will see regulation of glycolysis. Regulation of glycolysis is divided into two types of regulation. One is the hormonal regulation, and another is the allosteric regulation. So first we will see hormonal regulation. In the hormonal regulation, first we will see insulin. So insulin will favor the glycolysis by doing dephosphorylation of all the enzymes of glycolysis. And it will also induce glucokinase, as we have already seen in the first step of glycolysis. This induction of glucokinase will help in the regulation of blood glucose. So this is how insulin will favor the glycolysis. And the second one is glucagon. It inhibits the glycolysis by phosphorylating all the enzymes of glycolysis. And this phosphorylation will be done by increasing the cyclic AMP dependent protein kinase A. The phosphorylation of enzymes of glycolysis will be done by increasing the cyclic AMP dependent protein kinase A. So that is the hormonal regulation of glycolysis. Now we will see allosteric regulation. As we have discussed, glycolysis is regulated by three irreversible steps or three main enzymes, fine, which catalyze the irreversible step. First one is hexokinase and glucokinase. Second one is phosphofructokinase 1. And the third one is pyruvate kinase. So these are the three key enzymes which regulate the glycolytic pathway. This is the picture showing the regulation of glycolysis or allosteric regulation of glycolysis in liver as well as in the muscle. So in the liver, glucokinase enzyme, as we have seen, this glucokinase enzyme is induced by insulin, and it is inhibited by glucagon. Fine. While in the muscle, this hexokinase enzyme, it is not induced by insulin, but it gets inhibited by its end product, that is glucose-6-phosphate. So there will be the feedback inhibition of hexokinase via glucose-6-phosphate. Now in the liver, phosphofructokinase enzyme is stimulated by fructose-6-phosphate and fructose-2,6-bisphosphate, and it gets inhibited by citrate and glucagon. While in the muscle, phosphofructokinase is allosterically inhibited by ATP, that is high energy level, and it is stimulated by AMP, that is low energy level. that is in the muscle. Now, third enzyme, that is pyruvate kinase. So this pyruvate kinase enzyme in the liver is stimulated by insulin and it is inhibited by ATP, alanine and glucagon. While pyruvate kinase enzyme in the muscle is allosterically inhibited by ATP as well as alanine. So this is the allosteric regulation of three key enzymes of glycolysis in liver as well as in the muscle. And this is the picture which shows regulation of liver pyruvate kinase. So as we have discussed, whenever there will be the high blood glucose level, which means there is a reduced glucagon. So there will be the dephosphorylation. So in the dephosphorylation, pyruvate kinase will become active. And whenever there will be the low blood glucose level, which means high glucagon. So high glucagon will lead to the phosphorylation by increasing the cyclic AMP dependent protein kinase A, which will inactivate the pyruvate kinase. So that is the regulation of liver pyruvate kinase. So that was all about glycolysis. Now we will see various multiple choice questions. So this particular question was asked in AIIMS May 2013. Irreversible steps of glycolysis are catalyzed by, and the options are hexokinase, phosphofructokinase and pyruvate kinase, glucokinase, pyruvate kinase, glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase, C, hexokinase, phosphoglycerate kinase and pyruvate kinase, and D, pyruvate kinase, fructose 1,6 bisphosphatase and phosphofructokinase. As we have already seen, irreversible step of glycolysis are catalyzed by hexokinase and glucokinase, phosphofructokinase and pyruvate kinase. So the correct answer is A. Second question is, in glycolysis, the first committed step is catalyzed by, and the options are 2,3-DPG, glucokinase, hexokinase and phosphofructokinase. As we have already discussed, in glycolysis, first committed step or rate limiting step is catalyzed by phosphofructokinase. The correct answer is D. Another question is, enzyme not involved in substrate level phosphorylation. And the options are pyruvate kinase, phosphofructokinase, succinate thiokinase and phosphoglycerate kinase. So the pyruvate kinase is involved in substrate level phosphorylation in glycolysis. Then succinate thiokinase is involved in the substrate level phosphorylation in TCA cycle. Phosphoglycerate kinase is also involved in a substrate level phosphorylation in glycolysis. Phosphofructokinase is not involved in substrate level phosphorylation. Rather, in this step, there was a utilization of ATP. So the correct answer is B. These are my references. Thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe Biochemistry Basics by Dr. Amit. And don't forget to press the bell icon so you can get all the notifications from it. Thank you.